Hello and good afternoon, gamers. I'm Gregory. This is 1 in 20 D&D, and welcome to DnDaily number 64. I'm going to do something a little bit different here for my quick update on Vox Machina and Critical Role's Kickstarter. I'm actually going to show you the Kickstarter page. Check this out. Here we go. So, right now you have Critical Role, Legend of Vox Machina, animated special, sitting over $7.87 million with 57,000, nearly 58,000 backers. You probably just saw it roll up there a moment ago, and it may very well do that again here as we sit and watch. I am just shocked by this. If you have not gone to this Kickstarter, by all means, please go and check it out. It is you will not be disappointed, I promise. So, the information is awesome. That little video you see right there, they actually preview the anime, the animation. They kind of give you a little glimpse of what it might look like, which is super cool. So I'm thrilled. I can't wait. I mean, again, it's unbelievable how much they have, how much they've accomplished. It's mind-boggling. So congratulations. Keep it rolling. I think we're not even halfway there yet, which is incredible. So enough about that. I saw an article this morning that piqued my interest. It's all about initiative and different ways of handling initiative, because I guess some people don't like 5e D&D and how initiative is handled, and that's understandable. I guess it's not for everyone. For me, I don't have an issue with it. We've basically done initiative more or less the same way for like years and years. It's pretty much always been a d20 plus your dexterity, sort of. Back in the day, there were other modifiers. So like Advanced Dungeons & Dragons, second edition, some of that stuff. There were different modifiers. Like if you were going to cast a spell, it was like your dexterity plus the spell level. And that was your initiative for the round. And then there was like if you're fighting with a short sword, it might have had a +3 to your initiative, whereas a long sword might be a +8 to your initiative. And so it was your dex +3 or your dex +8 or what have you. So it was a little different back then. But as far as I recall, 5th edition, 4th edition, I think was similar. Maybe now I'm making a mistake. It's been a while since I played 4th edition. I would have to go back and look. But I've been playing 5th edition for a bit, and it just makes sense to me, I guess. For me, my logic and my simple, like I like to keep it simple. You know, KISS is a wonderful rule of thumb for just about everything. And it seems pretty simple. The only time it is ever kind of a question, I think, is if, you know, if two players or a player and an NPC tie. You know, what do you do if you both roll an 18 for your initiative? Well, it's usually pretty simple because whoever has the higher dexterity. So if we both roll an 18, and I roll an 18 and have a dexterity of 12, and you roll a 18 and have a dexterity of 17, you're going to go first. Pretty straightforward, unless you both have the same dexterity. And then there's other ways you can do it. You can do roll off. You can just be polite and say, oh, why don't you go first? Or, well, you know, usually at the table, it just works itself out. I don't see any kind of an issue with initiative for me in my games, in the games I've been in. It's never been a problem. One thing I've seen, I just mentioned recently, I started watching Sirens of the Realm. And now on Sirens of the Realm, they do things a little bit differently. Satine Phoenix, her style, what she does is she picks randomly the order of the initiative. So it's like, the first round, at least, you really don't know who's going to go next, which is kind of cool. It actually lends a certain uncertainty to the initiative, which is kind of exciting, And I dig that. That works. It's very different, but it works. And that's their house rule. That's her table rule, and everybody agrees to it. That's, you know, they're at her table and they dig it, and it works. So that's cool. I saw some other things, and I have actually been at games where this was the case. Like, for instance, one way to do this, and I can't remember if I've done it, but it makes sense, is whoever has the highest initiative, I don't think I've done this, but it works probably best at like a convention or something where you have a limited time for your game and you want to get things moving and not bogged down by millions of rolls. Whoever has the highest dexterity goes first, and then you go around the table. And that's just the way it goes. Now, one thing I saw, a little kind of an addendum to that in this article, which I thought sounded pretty cool, is whoever has the highest initiative goes first, and then to the right and to the left of that player, whoever has the highest dexterity goes second, and then you go around the table in that direction. That's pretty cool. I kind of like that. That speeds things up, and now once it's been established, you kind of know what's going to happen at the beginning of the round. Another way you could maybe do it, if you want to have a little bit of chance involved, is everybody rolls, and then whoever gets the highest roll, that's where it starts, and you work your way around the table. But there's lots of other things. So this article I was reading was a quick little blurb. I want to say it was from Comics Inc., but I'm not sure, so please forgive me. It was on, let me see if I can find it very quickly. It was on my phone, and I thought it looked very fascinating, so I said, oh, let me read this real quick, and let me see if, yes, it is. Here it is. It's by Comic Book. Whatever that is, I guess comicbook.net or comicbook.com. There you go. An article on comicbook.com. And one of the things they mentioned, and I haven't checked this out yet, but on the DM's Guild, if you don't know about DM's Guild, you might want to look into it. It's a very cool place to find one-shots, books, novels, character sheets, Dungeon Master stuff, all kind, entire adventures. There's all kinds of great stuff on there. Apparently, there's a new DM's Guild supplement called Elminster Takes Initiative. It's by Benjamin Eastman and Matt Dunn. And that's what this article was all about and what caught my attention. And I got to say, it was an interesting, very short, very interesting article. And it made me think, like, oh, yeah. Well, I mean, I do initiative essentially out of the book. I don't see any issue with that. But it certainly doesn't have to be done that way. I'm curious. I guess it's only $1 for this Elminster Takes Initiative. I might go check out this supplement just because maybe I'll find a new way to handle initiative. I don't know. There are alternatives to everything. You know, and this always comes to the bigger question in, like, how do you run your game? Do you run your game rules as written, R-A-W, raw, or do you run your game as, you know, whatever makes the rule of cool is another way to do it. You know, what makes the game more fun? You know, you don't have to do it either way. I tend to go rules as written, but if something either doesn't make sense to me or I want things to flow a little bit in the moment, I'll generally try to let things just roll for the sake of the game and look it up later. And sometimes I just let stuff slide all together because of the rule of cool. If it's an awesome thing and one of the players comes up with either an amazing idea or an amazing roll in the middle of a game, a lot of times I'm just going to let it happen because I want the older I get, I guess, and the more I see other people playing, the more interested I am in the story. Like, let's make an epic story. That's what's fun for me. You know, those are the things that I want to explore. Whether it's the way I describe things, whether it's the rulings I make, if it makes the story more interesting, that's what I'm engaging with lately. So, I don't know. So I might try a different way to do initiative. Probably if I do, I will try it out in a one-shot. Like, I'll run a one-shot because I want to run a one-shot. And I'll say, okay, guys, we're going to do initiative this way today. Just to see how it goes. That's a fun way to introduce or to try out new rules. And, hey, if you're a DM and you've got, like, this huge campaign and you're thinking you want to try something in the campaign, you know, jump on Roll 20 or jump in a group somewhere and just do a one-shot, a quick little, you know, 2-3-4-hour game where you can try out whatever idea you have is. Whether it's a new monster, new magic item, a new mechanic for the game, a new character class, whatever. Those are fun ways to introduce new information without breaking the game. You know, one shot, everybody's just going to have fun and kind of like, who cares? And then if it works, you can unleash it on your players in your grand adventure. Well, anyway, enough about initiative. Hey, thanks for tuning in today. I'm appreciating all of you. Hey, by the way, do you guys follow me on Instagram? I plug stuff on Instagram about D&D and whatnot and just my personal life and all that. Go check it out. You can find me pretty easily, 1 in 20 D&D. Gregory Festo, my name's right down here. You can find this is where I guess I need to. Oh, that made me just realize. Over there. I need to put a little Instagram bubble, huh? Put it on the to-do list. Hey, thanks for tuning in. I'll see you at a table someday. Keep rolling 20s. And remember, it's your game. Play your way.